a minute. Rushmore of country music, Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, Waylon Jennings, Kris Kristofferson. They arrive in New Zealand tomorrow for a series of concerts up and down the country. Of course, for country music fans, these four are giants. Some might argue they are country music.
This is the last cowboy song. The end of a 100-year war. The voices sound sad as
teaming up together. At least one critic, probably more critics have suggested it's because none of you can now fill the halls anymore on your own, that it takes four of you. How do you answer a critic
How
like that?
How kind of you to point that out.
Well, it's about time to leave, looks like.
Okay.
Well, we'll see you later, Paul.
Awful busy here, Paul.
It's different over here. It's real
Kris,
late over here.
Kris Kristofferson. Perhaps Kris Kristofferson, you'd like to comment on that one.
We have a lot of business being up on stage together, because we all have been referred to as wild men at one time or other in our life. And I think most of us do our best to get up there and tell the truth and sing from the heart.
Well, there's not a one in this group that can't fill any hall he plays on his own. That's not a true statement that you made there. I haven't had a show this year for my show with myself and my wife and the Carter family that hasn't been a sellout. And I know Willie sells out every place he plays. So does Waylon, so does Kris. It's not true that we can't make it on our own. As a matter of fact, we have trouble working into our schedule the shows for the Highwaymen for the four of us to perform together. We got four schedules to work out, and we have to do it a year in advance. We've taken a year of planning to make this tour happen in Auckland.
I might point out that I sell out smaller venues than they do.
I'll tell you, one more point, too, that if you ask another question like that, we'll burn your home.
I was a highwayman. Along the coach roads I did ride. With sword and pistol by my side. Many a young maid lost her baubles to my trade. Many a soldier shed his lifeblood on my blade. The bastards hung me in the spring of 25. But I am still alive.
You've all of you been described as, and this is another quote again, so don't jump down my neck about this, but you've all been described as survivors. Survivors of a collective 12 marriages, more than 115 years on the road, and untold bottles of whiskey and pills. What is all that left?
Who's he talking about?
That's just Kris he's talking about.
No, what about the rest of us?
This is the last cowboy song. The end of
wrong with the United States of America at the moment, if it's ill, if it is sick, if anything is ailing it, what do you think it might be?
There's a lot of things wrong with this country. I think the spirit is still here. The spirit just needs to scream a little bit. They say the wheel that does the squeaking is the one that gets the grease, so it's time for the spirit to scream a little bit.
Well, other than the fact that it reminds me a lot of the flag waving and choreographed patriotism that we had back in Nazi Germany a half a century ago. The fact that we got a one-party system which is in control of all three branches of our government. Lapdog media that's cranking out propaganda for the administration and make a Nazi blush. Other than that, we're doing pretty good.
If you ask me, one of the illnesses is that there's too much money being spent on military, and there should be more spent on education, welfare, young people, the children, the elderly, especially the elderly. There's always been a lot of things wrong with the country, but it's always been our obligation and opportunity to help straighten those things out. I love America, for instance, you know. I love this country.
Can I go to each of you in turn, just to finish this? The best country song you think was ever written? Kris Kristofferson, can we start with you? What do you think is the best country song?
Maybe Big River. I've often thought that may be the best song, country otherwise.
Can you do a couple of bars of that for me, would you mind?
I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and she tore me up every time I heard that drawl, southern drawl. Then I heard my dream move back downstream, cavorting in Davenport, and I followed you, Big River, when you called.
What about you, Johnny Cash?
Well, I'm overwhelmed because I wrote that song. The best song that I think was ever written, I don't know, I think probably country song. I Love You Because.
Want to give me the first verse of that, please, Johnny?
I love you because you understand, dear, every single thing I try to do. You're always there to lend a helping hand, dear. But most of all, I love you because you're you. Leon Payne wrote that.
Yes, Jim Reeves hit, and then we go to Waylon Jennings. What do you think, Waylon?
One of the best songs I ever heard, and several people recorded it. I recorded it, but that had nothing to do with it. It just says something I think is really great, and that's called Dreaming My Dreams. And it says, no matter how bad things have been, you know, like when it's in a relationship of any kind, you know, you should come out of it, you know, with no bitterness and go ahead with your life, you know. And you're not supposed to hate anybody if you ever love them. I don't think you can.
And Willie Nelson.
I think the best song I've ever heard, especially country song, is I'm So Lonesome I Could Cry, Hank Williams' song. One verse in particular I think is the greatest lines that I've ever heard. It's the silence of a falling star lights up a purple sky, and as I wonder where you are, I'm so lonesome I could cry.
This is the last cowboy song, the end of a 100-year war. Voices sound sad as they're singing.
Oh, yes. We recorded that interview with the Highwaymen the other day. They were in Norman, Oklahoma at the time.